In one of our earlier programs, we had seen some rituals and pastime activities of the Ows of Nagaland. In this program, we shall deal with the handicraft and handloom industry.
The National Award.
Nagaland is very rich in raw material. Of course, the main occupation is agriculture. But for leisure, the Ows engage themselves in handicraft and handloom. The Naga handlooms are colourful. Each tribe has its own distinctive traditional patterns and colours, which identifies the given tribe and status. In the past, the art of spinning cotton and weaving were quite popular. But this was the domain of women. Women who were skilful in this field had a very high chance of getting married to a skilful husband. This is how the Ows spin the cotton after separating the seeds from the cotton. Every household had a cotton field for their own use. When the threads are prepared, it is transferred to the loom, or sometimes the threads are dyed. Traditionally, the Ows used blue and red colors. The blue dye is obtained from the leaves of Strobilanthus flaccidifolius. The color varies from light blue to almost dark blue according to the strength of the dye used. When the desired color is obtained, the dyed threads are taken out and are kept for drying. Usually, when the white cloth gets dirty, they dye in dark blue. The red color is obtained from two species of madder, the root of a plant called Rubia cordifolia, found in this region. Once the threads are dyed, they are taken to the loom. It is a simple apparatus made of bamboo stick and wood. Today, many new weaving machines are introduced, but the same old apparatus is preferred by many. The young girl still loves to learn the art of weaving, and it is the duty of a mother to pass it on. The Naga cloth is considered one of the best fabrics which are produced by the simple loom. The dress that one wears reveals the identity of an individual in society. If women are good in weaving, the Naga men excel in working with bamboos. Basket and mat making are exclusively reserved for men. For this, patience and concentration are required to handle thin split bamboo or cane. This antique basket was used as a suitcase and it contained all kinds of things. Whether man or woman, the size and look of the basket and mat do not matter, as long as they meet the requirements. Given a dao and a bamboo, the owls can beautifully design a cup. All the kitchen items like plate, spoon and fork are all made of bamboo. Painting and wood carving are also in the blood of owls. They can work wonders with just a simple drilling machine, dao, chisel and hammer. Big trees were cut away to make the village gate door. The door and post are often covered with exquisitely carved tigers, birds, reptiles and other forms. The desired figure was outlined with charcoal and the rest was cut away. Animals' blood and soot were used to give the final touch. It was a difficult task to carve the village log drum. Expert artisans were engaged in designing the head portion. The body was laboriously hollowed out through the length of the drum. The bigger the hole, the clearer and louder the sound produced. It is said that there were no blacksmiths in the Aur region. But some immigrants from the neighboring state came and their descendants became the blacksmiths. Now this iron can be turned into a dao, spear, axe, sickle or bracelet. Here you go. This iron was brought from Assam. In the olden days, the Ows were engaged in the barter system. The local products like cotton, ginger, mat, basket, betel nut leaves and chili were taken to Assam, which took 4 to 5 days by foot. They were then exchanged for dried fish, salt and iron. The advancement of technology and abundance of raw material have helped the people to produce more goods with less manpower without wasting time. This gives them more time for social interaction.
The items which they used were mostly from the jungles. They were not trained. These days they are getting too much of this fabric, number of colors. That also, Ows, Nagas are the trained artists. And if we see today, I think Naga painters, Naga art, even music, even the art, even singing, or even this public, the way how they write, it is really wonderful.
This is Alemba. He received the President's Award for Handicrafts in 2001 and the Governor's Award in 2004. Besides the wooden tie and wooden belt for which he received the award, he also manufactures handbags, pen stands, photo frames, magazine racks, and many more. All these products are made of bamboo, wood and cane. The raw materials are easily available in the market and in the forest. For better quality and durability, some wood is dried, some bamboos are boiled, some are treated in chemicals, and to some salt and neem are applied. The speciality of Alemba is to design the traditional artifacts in a trendy way. Large quantities of these items are sent to Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai, Kolkata, China and Morocco. Alemba has done his 10 plus 2 only. He has no formal degree in this field. Since childhood, Alemba had an interest. He started making toys and vehicles of different types. Of course, now the government is sponsoring him to attend various workshops. Alemba has been to Mumbai, Delhi, China, London and Mauritius.
I went to IIT Bombay, but it was an interactive program between the designers and then we are craftsmen. So like we used to get ideas, they used to write it, they used to give us design in paper, we used to make it in product. So like that's how we used to interact each other. In the process of interaction also we used to learn how to create, how to design a product also, maybe updated designs like that. So like wherever I went, it was somewhat like an interactive program.
Sometimes the Nagaland Handicrafts and Handloom Development Corporation gives a subsidy and the rest he manages himself. Power failure in Nagaland is also a big drawback in business.
Whenever a contract is signed between some party, some buyer, I'll have to deliver the products within a specific period, within a short period, 2 months, 3 months. And if I get delayed or if I expire the date, there are great chances of refusing my consignment products.
The Nagas are skillful and talented. Perhaps the unemployed youth can be given a little encouragement and they will be successful entrepreneurs.
If we utilize our talent, we are creating a job ourselves. So what I feel is that we should, rather than we look for a job, we should create a job ourselves and then enjoy our life.
As Alemba has shown, even in a technology-rich world, tradition need not be sacrificed. Traditional art and artifacts can be a rich source of income for the skillful and innovative entrepreneur.
Partner.